In first unit, there are four important concepts. First one is the types of production or manufacturing methods. Second concept is the plant layouts. Third one is the productivity, and fourth one is the production planning and control. These are the four concepts in unit 1. First of all, I would like to explain about production or manufacturing. What do you mean by production or manufacturing? As per the definition, production consists of a sequence of operations that transforms some input form to a desired form known as output. Desired form may be output. Output may be product. What do you mean by product? A product is nothing but the physically produced item is known as product. So, any production process can be considered as transformation process. What do you mean by transformation? Transformation means conversion process. What we are going to convert? First, we are going to convert inputs into outputs. From this diagram, we can observe that the input may be in the form of men, materials, machines, money, methods, and so on. These are the inputs for the particular manufacturing organization. By using all these inputs, we are going to convert it into goods or services. Sometimes we can call it as products. Product is nothing but the output. Inputs are converted into outputs by using, by choosing certain manufacturing methods. The manufacturing methods may be based on the quantity produced, based on the frequency of production. We can categorize manufacturing methods into three categories. First one is the job order production. Second one is the batch type of production. Third one is the continuous type of production. Next, coming to the definition of production. Production is a transformation process and a conversion of inputs into outputs. For every organization, inputs are the men, materials, machines, money, manufacturing methods, information, technology, and so on. By using all these inputs, manufacturers are going to produce some products known as outputs. By using inputs are converted into outputs with the help of some transformation process. In transformation process, there are so many methods, that is product design techniques, process planning methods, production control techniques, and maintenance methods. Also, production is also defined as the step-by-step conversion of one form of material into another form through chemical or mechanical process to create or enhance the utility of the product to the user. So, we can give so many examples for manufacturing system or production system. For example, car manufacturing industry. A car is a product, a physical item, wood. So, bus, product is a bus. Motorcycle is one of product, physical, cell phone. Cell phone produced by various companies. Anyway, manufacturing company. Next, televisions and so on. From this diagram, it is also observed that every organization depending upon the customers, based on the customer tastes and preferences, products are planned, designed, accordingly produced based on the demand exists in the market. After producing goods or services in the plant, those goods are sent out into the various markets for selling. Again, customers are receiving the produced goods. So it is a cyclic process. Next, coming to the objectives of production. First, what are the objectives of production management? The objective of the production management is to produce goods or services of right quality and the right quantities at the right time and at the right manufacturing cost. These are the four important terms in the case of production management. Management people are going to concentrate only on these four important parameters. First one is the right quality. Mainly, customer accepts only quality products. How the cost can be reduced by the optimum utilization of available resources effectively. Next, second important parameter is the rate quantities. Depending upon the customer demand and timings, every organization has to produce required quantities based on the demand and supply conditions. If the manufacturer produces overstocks, again it is a loss to the organization. Therefore, optimum level of stocks should be maintained in the organization. Sometimes it may be shortfall. What are the drawbacks? Shortfall of demand means there is a shortage of products in the markets. And sometimes manufacturers are losing customer orders sometimes. It is again loss. Understocks is also not permitted. Therefore, every time organization has to maintain some optimal level of stocks. Similarly, right time. What do you mean by right time? Delivery or timeliness of delivery of product is very, very important parameter from customer angle. And finally, right manufacturing cost. The product should be made at the reasonable cost along with the quality. These are the two compromising parameters for reducing cost. Next, two types of production are types of manufacturing methods. Based on the quantity involved in the manufacturing and on the frequency of producing the items, known as regularity of manufacture, the manufacturing activities or production can be grouped into three major classes. They are, first one is the job order production, second one is the batch type of production, third one is the continuous production, also known as mass production. First, I can concentrate on the job order production. We are going to discuss about job order production. First of all, what do you mean by job order production? Before entering into the definition, what is the real life examples comes under this type of production? In real life, some of the products you can observe: large turbo generators, large engines, boilers, ship building, aeroplanes, etc. These are the examples comes under job order production. From these examples, we can observe one thing. Such type of items are manufactured based on the customer order. Only specific customers requires these type of products, not all customers. Therefore, based on the customer order, production is started. So these are the examples comes under job order production. Next, coming to the definition. In the name itself, we can observe one thing. Job order production means, based on the customer order, products are produced. Some of the organizations may be service-oriented organizations. In that case, organizations may provide some service to the customers. So, I can define a job order production like this. Job order production is the manufacture of products to meet specific customer requirements of special orders. Special orders means large turbines, large engines, railways, trains, railway coaches, trucks, shipbuilding, etc. and so on. Next, I can explain about some of the characteristics of job order production or some important features. First important parameter is the quantity produced. In job order production, the quantity produced is small or less quantities. And is normally concerned with the special projects, models, or special machinery or equipment to perform specialized and specific tasks. For producing these type of items, manufacturing time takes lot of time. Usually, quantity produced is very, very less. Why? Because in case of shipbuilding, depending upon the size of the ship, ship may be manufactured in 1 year or 1.5 year or 2 years, depending upon the size of the ship. Therefore, time taking is more. Therefore, quantity produced is valuably less quantity. Next, another important characteristic is the regularity of manufacture. How frequently products are produced? Under job order production, there are three categories. A small number of pieces produced only once. A small number of pieces produced intermittently when the need arises. Intermittent means sometime we can start manufacturing, sometime we can stop to produce that product. That is intermittent. Stop and again restart. And one more category is a small number of pieces produced periodically. Periodically means based on the time to time demand varies in real life situations. Accordingly, manufacturers are going to fluctuate supply based on the demand conditions. Therefore, a small number of pieces produced periodically at known time intervals. If there is a demand in the market, then only manufacturers are going to produce goods. This comes under make to order category. Also, this type of production has a lot of flexibility of operation. Means what? In this type of production, any type of work we can perform. Because in job order production, all machines belongs to general purpose machines. What is the specialty of general purpose machines? Any kind of operation we can perform with that machines, known as general purpose machines. Therefore, one important point in this is, in this job order production, general purpose machines are required. And also, this type of production requires manpower, regarding to manpower. Particularly, this is a job order production. Usually, under job order production, usually orders are not repeated. Therefore, each time, job is different. Therefore, skilled persons are needed. Only skilled persons are able to do these type of jobs. Therefore, highly skilled people are required due to frequent changes in the product variety. Next, coming to the layout. This type of production requires process layout. In the next concept, I will explain about two layouts. Anyway, briefly, I would like to explain. What do you mean by layout? Layout means it is the arrangement of machines, particularly machines. Arrangement of machines within the available space, so that each operation is performed at the point of greatest convenience. In process layout, usually occupies more area. Why? Because machines are arranged based on the functions, based on the groups. So, occupied area is more for process layout. Next important characteristic is the PPC. What is the meaning of PPC? PPC means production, planning and control. PPC, production planning control, becomes difficult in the case of job order production. Why it is difficult? Each time job is different. Same time we are not dealing with the same product. Different type, each time different type. Variety of products. Therefore, PPC becomes complex. Under this production, orders are not repeated. This is a rare situation. Therefore, production control is complicated. And the next important point is we are applying process layout in job order production. Therefore, material movements are longer, and sometimes production may be interrupted. Ultimately, it takes more manufacturing time when compared with the other types of production. Next, coming to the disadvantages of the Java tools, the main disadvantages or limitation is cost of labor is high. Why? Because this Java production requires high skilled persons, high skilled labor. Therefore, the cost spent on this skilled labor is more. Usually, there are three types of labors: skilled labor, skilled persons, unskilled persons, semi-skilled persons. Usually, organizations are going to pay more amount of salary to the skilled persons, less amount of money to the unskilled persons, and average to the semi-skilled persons. So, this is a disadvantage. And one more disadvantage is production planning and control. All the three becomes complex in case of job order production. Next, second type of production is the batch type of production. In the name itself, we can observe one thing. Batch production is also known as intermittent production. What do you mean by intermittent? Sometime we can start the manufacture. Some other time we can stop the manufacture. Again we can restart the manufacture. Therefore, this type of production is also known as intermittent production. What are the examples? Before entering into the definition, what are the real life examples comes under this category, that is batch type of production. This type of batch production is useful in the manufacture of machine tools, books, pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, ready-made garments, air coolers, and so on. These are some of the examples. Particularly, all medium scale organizations follows this type of batch type of production. It comes under medium scale industries. Usually in society, three types of organizations exist: small scale, medium scale, and large scale organizations. Next, coming to the definition of batch production. What do you mean by batch production? Universally, I am giving universally accepted definition. Batch production is the manufacture of a number of identical items, either to meet a specific order, either to meet a specific customer order, or to satisfy continuous demand. In this type of production, the product is produced in lots means small batches, rather than continuous manufacture. Particularly, this manufacturing method is best suited when the rate of production means what? Number of units produced in a unit of time exceeds, when the rate of production exceeds rate of consumption. Number of, what do you mean by rate of consumption? Number of units or number of items consumed in a unit of time. This is nothing but the rate of consumption. One important point is batch production is best suited when the rate of production exceeds the rate of consumption. From this statement, we can observe that every time the company maintain some stock of items in the operations. Stock of items. Majority of the operations follows this batch type of production. It is applicable for medium scale industries. Next, coming to the characteristics of the batch production. First and foremost characteristic is, in batch type of production, plant facilities and machinery are used to produce limited variety of jobs. Limited variety. One important observation is limited variety of jobs. When we see job order production, in job order production there is lot of variety, more varieties of products are manufactured under job order production. But in case of batch production, variety of the products are limited. Not that much more. Similarly, this batch production belongs to short production times. Short production times. What do you mean by short production? In batch production, we are going to deal with many products, definitely, but limited in number. But each variety, some time, maybe 1 week or 15 days. Some product may be 15 days, some product may be 1 month. So, depending upon the demand of the product, we can start and we can start the product. Therefore, it comes under short production runs. Next, coming to the setup cost. Setup cost is high because each time job is changing, some money we have to spend on setting up all these plant facilities. So, costs are more, high setup cost. Because of more setups, particularly in batch type of production. Next, coming to the manpower. In batch production, very few skilled persons are enough, but most of the persons related to semi-skilled people. Therefore, we can save some money on manpower side. We can minimize cost spent on labor. And coming to the machinery. Machinery can be categorized into two categories. First one is the general purpose machines, second one is the special purpose machines. Particularly for batch production, a combination of general purpose machines and some special purpose machines are also required. A combination of general and special purpose. Most of the machines are related to general purpose machines and some few special purpose machines we are going to use. Next, coming to the layout, which type of layout is preferable for this batch production? For this production, process layout is required, same as that of job order production. also in this type of production, the size of batch, that means how much quantity to produce, and schedules of production, means when to produce. These two are the important parameters. As soon as one batch is completed, the same plant can be used to produce some other batch of other products. So in this slide, I am going to explain about continuous production. In the name itself, you can observe one thing, continuous. Continuous means highly demanded products are manufactured constantly without storage at any point in the manufacturing process. Throughout 365 days, these plants run. Before entering into the actual definition, first of all, I would like to explain what are the examples comes under this type of manufacturing method. What are the examples comes under this continuous production? Steel plants comes under continuous production. Cement factories comes under continuous production. Oil refineries comes under continuous production. Food grades comes under continuous production. Continuously products are produced under this type of production because the product is very, very high demand. High demand exists in the society. For every vehicle, fuel is needed. It may be in the form of petrol or diesel, or it may be a gas. Therefore, it is one of the important, highly demanded product. So, oil refineries comes under continuous production. Steel plants produces steel. Everybody knows that applications of steel for construction of building, for construction of bridge, highways, dams, fabrication of machinery, everywhere steel is needed. Therefore, that type of companies never stops. Similarly, food grades. Food is the main thing for every human being. Therefore, farmers are always to produce rice, wheat, vegetables, etc. All are highly demanded products. Similarly, cement. From construction side, cement is a highly demanded product. Therefore, I would like to define continuous production like this. Continuous production is usually associated with large quantities, huge amounts, large quantities. Within less time, you can produce more quantities by using automatic machines. Therefore, for continuous production, automatic machines are needed. Therefore, we can improve the rate of production when compared with the rate of production. Usually, in mass production, production rate is almost same as that of consumption rate because highly demand products are produced. Dairy products also comes under highly demand product. Next, coming to the definition. In continuous production or mass production, it is sometimes continuous production is also known as mass production. In continuous production, highly demanded products are manufactured constantly without storage at any point of time. Second important point is continuous production is the specialized manufacture of all identical items or exact items on which the equipment is fully engaged. It is usually associated with large quantities and with a high rate of demand. The main important point considered in continuous production is it deals with the large quantities and with the high rate of demand. Continuous production are of two types. One is the mass production and another one is the flow production. Most of the persons don't know the difference between mass production and the flow production. There is a slight difference. Majority of the people are calling continuous production is same as that of mass production. That is wrong. There is some slight difference. I would like to discuss these things. In mass production, large number of identical parts are produced and the plant is kept flexible for manufacture of other similar products. Next, coming to the flow production. Flow production means the plant is designed for manufacture of specific products like automobiles, steel plants, chemical industries, that means oil refineries, etc., which is having very little flexibility. Finally, I can say one thing. In mass production, there is a small flexibility there to produce some other related product. But in case of flow production, there is no flexibility when compared with the mass production. Next, coming to the some more features related to mass continuous production. This type of production requires product load. In the coming topics, I will explain about this layout. Briefly, I would like to explain product layout. In product layout, all the machines are arranged according to the sequence of operations. Next, coming to the machines employed, which type of machinery we are going to use? This continuous production requires special purpose machines. Can you name one of the special purpose machinery? All automation machines, automation comes under this category. The major advantage of this type of automation machinery, production rate is very, very high. Within less time you can produce huge quantities. Coming to the manpower side, this type of product requires unskilled labor. Majority of the works are done by machinery. Only unskilled people are sufficient. What is the role of unskilled people? For loading the raw materials onto the first machine, downloading the finished goods from the last machine, and maintenance of all the machines, etc. Therefore, we can reduce the money spent on unskilled people And in this type of continuous production, material flow is smooth. Therefore, smooth flow of materials we can observe. And also, line balancing is also very, very simple. Coming to the merits of the continuous production, the rate of production is more. This is a merit of the continuous production. Also, maintenance of better quality. Quality of the product improves. Quantity discounts can be achieved during purchasing of high volume of raw materials. What do you mean by quantity discounts? Manufacturing companies are going to purchase raw materials in huge quantities at a time. If they purchase raw materials in huge quantities, means they can save some money. Vendors are going to give some discounts on the purchased materials, raw materials. This is the advantage. They can save some money on purchasing. Quantity discount benefit. Similarly, unit cost is less. Why it is less? Because within less time, we are producing huge quantities. Therefore, if the production time is less, means that is linked to the cost. Unit cost is less. We can offer that product at lowest price. Next, coming to the cost. Labor cost is relatively low. This is the advantage. Because this production requires unskilled people. Next, coming to the disadvantages or demerits of the continuous production. Very few. Disadvantages are very few. Therefore, what are they? High risk. First one is the high risk when demand increases. Already told, continuous production deals with the large quantities. If the demand falls suddenly, what happens? High risk is great loss of product. That is severe disadvantage. And also, initial investment is more. Okay. On which resource we are going to invest more effort, particularly on machines. Which machines we are going to use? Special purpose machines, sometimes automatic machines. They are costliest machines, crores of things. Therefore, initial investment is more. How we can recover? By the utilization of that equipment. Next, third important demerit is the flexibility, less flexibility. In case of continuous production, we are not going to deal with some other product. We are dealing with same product, same identical product. Less flexibility. Very few demerits of the continuous production. In this slide, I am going to compare all the three types of productions. That means job order production, batch type of production, and continuous production. First characteristic is the volume of production. What do you mean by volume of production? That means quantity produced. Quantity produced. Under job order production, quantity produced is less. Sometimes one. Sometimes we can call it as few. Next, coming to the batch type of production. Volume of production is limited in number. Variety is there, sure, but limited in number. Next, coming to the continuous type of production. Continuous production deals with a large volume, huge quantities. Next, second important characteristic, layouts. job order and batch type of production requires process layout. These two type of layouts occupies more floor area when compared with the other layout, that means product layout. Continuous production requires product layout. It occupies less area. Next, coming to the product variety. Job order type comes to the large variety. Batch type of production comes under medium variety. The continuous production comes under very few, or sometimes you can say strictly one. Deal with only one product. Regarding to next two point is setup time. Regards to setup time. So setup times are more in case of job order production and less in continuous production. Because in case of continuous production, it deals with the one type of product, identical product. Next, coming to the manufacturing cycle time. Manufacturing cycle time is more in job order production, less in continuous production, that means short or medium time in case of batch type of production. Coming to the material flow in the plant, material movements are longer in case of job order production because of the layout, that means discontinuous. In batch production also discontinuous, whereas in case of continuous production, it is uninterrupted production. Uninterrupted means it is a smooth flow. Raw materials enter at one end and flows in a line from one process to the next and leaves at the other end as a finished good. This is known as uninterrupted production, flow, material flow. Next, coming to the plant and machine. In job order production, general purpose machines are needed. In continuous production, special purpose machines are needed. Whereas in case of batch type of production, a mixture of general purpose and special purpose machines. Most of the machines may be general purpose, very few machines may be special category. And the eighth point is the cost per unit. Under job order production, cost per unit is very, very high because usually depending upon the manufacturing time. Whereas in case of continuous production, it takes less time to produce one item, therefore cost per unit is low. Next, coming to the batch type of production, cost per unit is medium, not high, not low, it is a medium cost. This is about to comparison among three types of production systems. This slide shows the production systems can be classified as three categories: job shop or job order production, batch production, and continuous production. This from this diagram it is observed that this is the graph between product variety and production volume. An x-axis, you have taken product variety, y-axis, you have taken production volume. Job shop is dedicated to the high variety, product variety is high, but the production volume is low, quantity low, variety is high. Next, coming to the continuous production. Mass production also comes under continuous production. It deals with the large quantities, that means production volume is high or more. But coming to the variety, no variety is there in case of continuous production. Say every time you are dealing with identical items, therefore product variety is low and production volume is more. More production volume and low product variety comes under continuous production. Coming to the third one, batch type of production. It is a mid variety. Varieties are limited in number, product variety. I mean product variety. Mid volume and mid variety. Medium scale industries, it is total.